So hi, today we are coding for Prim's algorithm. So first of all, in the Prim's algorithm function, we will pass an array which will contain number of vertices in the rows and number of vertices in the columns. And for each vertex, we have an edge with a particular weight. For example, the value of array 0, 1 will contain the weight 3 because it has an edge between 0 and 1. So we will pass that array which contains the weight of all the edges in the given graph, and we'll pass the number of vertices in the given function. Now, as we have discussed, that Prim's algorithm require three parameters. One is parent, one is visited, and one is weight. So we'll compute an array for all these three parameters. So first we'll compute an array of parent, which is an integer array, and we'll dynamically allocate it. Second one is of visited, whether the node is visited or not. So we'll maintain a boolean array for that. And the third one is of weight. So what is the weight of the given node after calculation? So first of all, we'll initialize the weight as int max value, which is approximately, we'll consider that it is infinite for all the nodes. And as we have discussed, that for the source node, we will take the value of weight as 0 and the value for parent as -1. So we have taken 0 as the source node, and the weight of 0 is 0, and the parent 0 is -1 because it is the source node. Now, for remaining v minus 1 vertices, we will compute the minimum weight vertex that we can get. So from these vertices, we will calculate the minimum weight vertex that we can get. So first of all, we have initialized the weight 0 for the node 0, so we'll get 0 first. So we'll compute a mini function for that, for the computation of min vertex. So we'll compute it. Let us assume for some time that we are getting the index value which has the minimum weight. So we are getting first 0 over here for minimum weight. The vertex which we are getting is 0, so we'll mark it as true. Because we are exploring that vertex, so we'll mark that it as visited. So first of all, we mark the 0 vertex as visited. Now we'll compute all the neighboring vertex of that particular vertex. So we'll observe the neighboring vertexes as 1 and the neighbor vertex as 3, which has an edge from the given vertex. So 1 and 3 has an edge, so we'll compute it for that. So first of all, we'll check this condition for all the vertices from 0 to v, which has min vertex j not equal to 0. So array of min vertex j shows that if the value is present for the weight of a given edge in the array matrix, then it will have an edge. So for example, array of 0, 1 will contain a value 3 in the array matrix, but because it has a weight value 3. So if the value is non-zero, then that means it has an edge with some weight. So first of all, we'll check this condition for the given graph. Secondly, we will check if the array is if the particular node is visited or not. So in this condition, we have seen that we have not visited the first node and the third node. So second condition is checked by this parameter. And the third condition is we will check that if the weight of the node is greater than the weight of the array matrix. So first we will check if the weight of the node which we have initialized it is greater than the weight which we are checking. So array of 0, 1, as we can see, have the weight value 3. So obviously the weight of 0, 1, which is infinity, has greater value than it is stored in that array. So we will make the update. So what the update we will make? Weight of j will be equal to array of min vertex comma j. So at this particular weight, we will make the value 3, which is stored in that array. Now we need to make the changes in parent also. Initially we doesn't have any parent, so now the parent of 1 will be 0. So for all these values, similarly for 3, we will compute this. Similarly, after exploring all these values, we will go for 1 and then explore its neighbors, check whether it is visited or not, and then update the value. Similarly for 2 and similarly for 3. So for all the nodes, we will calculate the value, and at last we will find the minimum spanning tree. Now we will calculate this min vertex, how we are getting this min vertex through mini function. So we will calculate that. So for min vertex, we will see that function. It is taking an integer array of weight a boolean array of visited and number of nodes. So now we'll make a value mini v as int max. It will contain the maximum value, and we'll make an index so now for I equal to 0 to v, we will check that how many nodes are visited or not, and for every node we'll see that whichever node has the minimum weight. So for all the vertices we will check if it is not visited and the weight at I should be less than mini v, which has the initially it has the value of int max. So we'll update the value of mini v as weight of I and update the value of index as I. And at last we'll return index. So this function is the mini function which will return the value of the node which has minimum weight and which is not visited. So this function will return the index, and this index is stored as min vertex and is computed for the Prim's algo. So thank you for watching.